goodbye Google Calendar and say hello to Notion Calendar. Before I share 3 reasons why you should try Notion Calendar, plus a bonus tip at the end that you don't want to miss out, let me first show you how to set up your Notion Calendar. First, if you have not already installed Notion Calendar, open Google and search for Notion Calendar. We'll click on the first link, and then navigate to the downloads page. From here, we'll choose the version that works for your desktop. So once you have opened up the Notion Calendar app, you'll be prompted to sign in to a Google account. So if you have been using your Google Calendar, you can see all your existing meetings and events in your Notion Calendar app. My personal reason for using the Notion Calendar is its clean and minimal design. It looks great not only on your desktop, but also on your phone. On top of that, the desktop menu bar is compact and neatly arranged, allowing me to easily see my schedule. Similarly, there's a well-designed home screen widget for your phone as well. Okay, but really the first main reason to use Notion Calendar is because it syncs with Notion. If you're a heavy Notion user, this could be the only reason you need. To sync a Notion database to your Notion Calendar, click on Open in Calendar in the top right corner of your database view. Note that this view needs to be either in the Timeline view or Calendar view. And once you click on the button, that's it, a one-click sync. Why is this useful? Having synced my project database, I can now easily keep track of my project deadlines on my Notion Calendar. But I also need to frequently check my content calendar in Notion to keep up with my publishing schedule. It can be a troublesome process to switch between different pages in Notion just to check my project dates and my content calendar. But now, I can sync multiple databases to my Notion Calendar, so I also sync my content calendar just by opening the respective page and click on Open in Calendar. This allows me to consolidate all my important dates in one place, together with my existing Google Calendar events. The second reason to use Notion Calendar is the built-in shortcuts. You can view all the keyboard shortcuts by clicking the question mark icon at the bottom right corner and selecting keyboard shortcuts. I will show you a few of my favorite ones. You can use Command-Ctrl-K to show the menu bar widget. This can be helpful when you're using other apps in full screen and you want to quickly check your current schedule without moving away from the current window. Next, you can use D-W-M to switch between day view, week view, and month view. It's really handy and easy to remember. D for day, W for week, and M for month. Lastly, you can click on the dot key to go to a date. This can help you easily jump to a specific date or find a date for your events or projects. For instance, if you're planning an event and know you need about 6 weeks to plan for it, just type 6 weeks and it will show you the date after 6 weeks. And then you can jump to the date and mark down the event date. The third reason to use Notion Calendar is the ease of sharing your availability with your friends or clients. When you want to find a time to meet someone, here's what you do. Suppose this friend of yours is from New York. First, you can travel to their time zone by clicking on the Z key and search for their time zone. You can now see both your time and their time to find a time that might fit. Then click on the S key to start creating blocks of your available time. Once done, you can pick the duration on the sidebar and also toggle on the scheduling before hitting on create. Now you can copy and paste this text and send it to your friend or client. If I paste and open this link on the web, you can see how easily the other party can select and confirm a time. Here's a bonus tip for you if you enjoy time blocking. Most people I know and including myself use time blocks with general terms such as deep work. The actual tasks that I need to get done are listed somewhere else, like in Notion. With Notion Calendar, I can now sync it with my task database, and once it's synced, I can see my tasks at the top of each day on the calendar. From here, I can easily drag and drop any of the tasks onto my time blocks and set a start and end time for each specific task. This method enhances time blocking by being highly intentional about how you spend your time. And that concludes my introduction to the Notion Calendar. So will you be switching to Notion Calendar? Let me know in the comments and see you in the next video.